Hello for Wednesday, July 23rd already, and we had so many breakouts today. It took an extra couple of hours after the close to get ready for this video with updating the site and then browser problems anyway. But you won't find another site out there that had 10 breakouts in one day. That was today. These bear market rallies are just great. Look at this. This is the Dow 15-minute chart. We've showed this chart many times, and this yellow line here, this was the high back here on the 9th. It became resistance. It broke through this on this, whatever this date was, around the 17th, and it should become support. We've talked about it before. This the Dow broke down in the morning. Bad earnings reports from Wachovia and Amex and so forth, and it broke down. But it came right down to this line, just a little bit below it. But the next candle, it moved right back up for it if you were playing the dip. And you'll notice here we've got stochastics. Of course, that went back above 20 as well. So if you played that dip, great. If you didn't, you made very good move, a couple hundred points off of that. If you didn't play the dip, this was the other thing. We were watching a three-minute chart in the chat room. All this consolidation in this very tight range all afternoon long. And then in the last hour, it broke out of this range. That's exactly the right timing. If it happens that way quite often late in the day, if some momentum kicks in, then everyone doesn't want to be caught on the wrong side, so they jump in as well. That's exactly what happened. And here you picked up about 100 or so points from this level on up. It was great. The end of the day, those are the things to look for right now. Because of this pullback, this is a possibility of a trend line that's set up back here from the 16th, and then the touch on Tuesday, and then the second touch here. So this would be the area. It happens to also fall right in with the 50-period EMA on the 15-minute chart below 11,042. So on a pullback, that would be the place to short down to 11,348. That is a possibility. We are getting overbought on the market at the moment. I wanted to show something else. This is on the daily chart of the Dow. And as you can see, all this gain that has run back up into what was the intraday low back in March, and very close to what the intraday low, in January, and then close to the low in March right here. Now that, so it 11,634, so that's only 34 points higher, is where this these intraday ones were back in January. Then 11,726 is where the March lows were. So we would expect some resistance to that point. On the daily chart, we do see the stochastics is above 80 already. It's up at 94, but it can stay there, as you can see, for a while. We have RSI just above 50, so it has room to run. But I think a pullback still, maybe it'll keep running up, but eventually we're going to get a pullback here, which would really be healthy for it, actually. Then we've got this Standard & Poor's 500. It did the same thing we talked about in the morning update, that it have to break either above this line, which turned out to be congestionary and a good play, or above this high, a little bit higher up. Either one, you made good money on that, playing that trade today, just as we talked about and as you've seen on the chart anyway. And you can see here we've got overbought on stochastics, and RSI is now at 74, and it's closed right at 1,277 spot on to where we have this line drawn all along anyway. So we've got the Russell. Now the Russell outperformed all of them. No place to catch this one except for the first move up, and then of course after this consolidation, just like the others, around 708, it added another 8 points, or $800 per contract. If you have a global futures account, it only ties up between $300 and $500 per contract in margin fees, and so you made $800 on each contract. And it's, anyway, you can know it's a great deal. Now we know the Russell is going to pull back. The first point will be the 702. We know it's going to pull back, absolutely. We don't know when, but we know it's going to pull back. You can see right now it's overbought at 80 and 100 on stochastics. Maybe it'll do it right away, maybe not, but this is too weak, and we've seen it over and over again. It will pull back. Now on the daily for the Russell, you can see what it's done. It congested all around the 38 or 62%, depending on which you're counting it, from the high or the low. They're in the same point. So the first level of Fibonacci, this is where it congested, right under the 200 period. Then it ran up, It congested right around the 50%. That's where it was on Tuesday when we talked about that congestion. It ran up almost to the 62 or 38%, and that's at 719. Look left, 717 over here is resistance. It was support here. Support here, so now it becomes resistance. Plus the 61 or 62 or 38%, 719, that's going to be resistance. Even if it breaks above it, I think it's going to pull back to it. Those are places to watch on these major averages. So let's get to the additions to the watch list. You know, 10 breakouts. I just can't get over that in a weak market. Generally, it was strong on Tuesday, but I think 10's great. Okay, this is one of the members brought up. Corinthian College, COCO, we mentioned it in the morning update. It was then around 1330 and 1334. We said that one has a strong likelihood of a breakout if VIAM comes in. And look at that, VIAM really did come in. It ran additionally from there up as high as 1370. But look, the reason we still like it is this golden cross. We said it's going to happen, and it's just about to happen now. It's just a few cents, the 200 day is just a few cents above. And we're saying over 1370 of that high, or on a pullback, we think a COCO will be a mover still. DWA over $32. We've got a little room to run on this. It was up 3.92, so not a lot. The VIAM was rather weak. We'd like to see increased VIAM. If it runs up to it and then consolidates, we always like that better. Consolidation close to it a few days, and then a nice move above it. That's on DWA. Now we've got a low price stock, EGMI. Over 76 cents, or over here you can see 80 cents. Now it's pulling back. The VIAM increased later on in the day on Tuesday, so maybe this is going to not work out. But watch this on the pullback. If those that like to play stocks under a dollar, you may want to buy a little bit down in here. Not enough that you're going to worry about if you lose some, but some people like to do that. If not, wait for it to bounce fully back up, and then a move back over the 76 cents might be a possibility. DTG, this another member in the chat room brought this one up to us, and we've got several that look very similar to this. DTG over 374 on good VIAM with a tight stop. That's because we don't know the reason for this fall. Sometimes we don't like to read the news. You can if you like. Dollar Thrifty really fell from this 12 down to 230. So maybe it fell too much. I don't know. All we know is if it can move above this line, which is about 370, if it has good VIAM, it's a possibility it will continue up. Where? We don't know. Maybe up to this first line here, which is over $5. Maybe it won't get that far. That's why we're saying keep a tight stop on these and see how the VIAM. The VIAM is going to dictate how well they do. QLTY, this one did break above this resistance at 256, 257. That's what happens in a strong market. We love to present you ones before they break it, but we had it and it broke out. So, but look, the VIAM's increasing a little bit. There was very strong VIAM early in the week. So if this continues up, if it pulls back a little bit, it might be a buyer for its continuation for here. First stop would be 279. That's the 50-day EMA. Okay, then we've got bank rate. This is very similar to the other one we showed here. We've got a gap to fill up at 3250, 3260 area. Right here is at 3022. And on rate, we're saying over the high of 3042. Of course, it needs more VIAM. The VIAM here was kind of weak. Just average. If we have more VIAM, this is a chance that it could at least fill the gap. And we'll see how it goes. But sometimes if it fills the gap, then they are shortable in some cases. How about RES over 1750? That's in this first little area here, or the top is 1772. It's had good VIAM the last couple days, better than average VIAM. Stronger VIAM is what we look for. And lastly, we've got MBRK, yet the third one that's in this gap situation. Over $2.34 will put it into the gap, but look, down here, the VIAM's pretty weak, only 100, it's 1.2 million shares, but weaker than what it was over here when it had 5 or 6 million. So we'll see how that does above 234. It's possibility of a play. It has had this death cross here, but that won't stop us to play at least as a short-term trade. So that's what we got for this Wednesday. I appreciate you coming by the site. Please tell other folks, when we get 10 breakouts in one day, I hope everyone is coming to the site because there's just a lot of money to be made. Hope you're making it. Have a great day trading. We'll be back tomorrow with some new ideas. Bye-bye.